Back around 2002, I was still in high school, and I was a really hardcore atheist at the time. I believed that the cause of the majority of the world's problems was religion. And now I see it differently. Now I recognize that it's not religion per se, but rather irrational belief systems that permit the initiation of violence upon others. And religion is not the most popular or common irrational belief system that does this. It is the state. It is the political process itself. And at the time, I was completely oblivious to this fact. And so I jumped right for the trick, for the trick of the political process, which was recognizing the unfairness of how my particular special interest group of atheists were being treated unequally under the law. And so I started campaigning and advocating for equal treatment, you know, in God We Trust, on currency, under God and the Pledge, religious symbols on public property, and so on. And so I had a whole bunch of stuff to sink my teeth into to argue about for how it's unequal and not fair, just like how gay people are able to sink their teeth into gay marriage. And it was all a trick. That's what it was. It was just one giant trick for me to completely look past the basic question of whether we should have a state currency in the first place, whether we should have a state pledge of allegiance in the first place, whether we should have a bunch of public property owned by the state in the first place, whether we should have a political process that enables the majority to initiate violence upon the minority and impose their will upon them, whether we should have a state in the first place. Because that's what we have to recognize, that whenever we are advocating for any kind of political action, no matter what it is, we are advocating that we should have the right to violently impose our will over the people who disagree with us. We should recognize that the smallest minority on earth is not gay people, it is not atheists, it is the individual. When are we going to drop all of these special interest groups that we continue to campaign for and begin to recognize the rights of the individual?